Hi everyone. In this video, I will show you step to export Oracle database and store the dump file into your client computer instead of a database server. And we know that when we run the data bomb export command, the dump file will go to the server with your database is running. For example here, I connect to Oracle database server. This is my database server. Then I have some Oracle directory here. This is one of my directory. You can see here, this is the directory in our Linux computer, in our database server. For example, I try to execute the export command from my client. Then I saw that the directory will be data bomb directory. Then I connect to the system user with my alias from the database server. Then we will see. This command we are running in client computer against the database server. Then you see here, we have the dump file. The dump file will store in U01 in the server. Then we have no way to create any Oracle directory in the database server. We point to the folder in our client computer. Then if you don't have access to the server via FTP or SFTP, we will have no way to copy this file from the server to the client. You can use some ways like share the folder in the server and mount it in the client. In this video, we will use another way. We will use database link to export data from database server. To use this, we need to have a small database in our client. Just a small database is okay. For example, I have a small database in my Windows computer here. Now I will create a database link point to the user in the database server. We can use the private database link or public database link. To easy to use, I will create a public database link here. You can see the command. Create public database link. We will name the database link is OraVNBRD. Then we will connect to the user in the database server. I connect to the system user, then the password. Then next, we will using Oracle alias, the alias to connect to database server. You can see this alias one time before. We connect to system, then alias OraVNBRD. Then we create a public database link. This command, we have something wrong here. We missed the two keywords. Okay, now we have a database link to a system user in the database server. Then we will create a directory to save our dump file for the future export. For example, I want to save the dump file to this folder. Then I will use the command like create directory, then directory name, you can name anything here. Then point to a folder in the server. We will to the folder in our client computer. This is the client computer running on Windows OS. So the folder will be D drive. So now we have a database link to database server, then the folder in our local computer. Then we will use the export command. It's almost same with the export command we used to run before. Then we will use the directory in our local computer. Then we will add in one more keyword here. It's called network link. Then the network link will use the database link. So now you need to remember that we need to use network link with our database link. Then we execute this command against our local database, not the database server. We connect directly to the system user here. You can see here we have the log file and the dump file in our local computer. It is generating our result. So after complete, so we you can see we have the dump file in our local computer. So we done here. All we need to remember is we need to create database link from our local database to point to the server. Then when we export, we will export against our local database, not database server. Then we will use the network link with a link to our database server. We also need to use this way to export database which running in read-only mode. You know that in read-only mode, we cannot export directly that data from a data pump command. Then we can use this way to export it.